Hello everyone, welcome to the channel DevDbQa. In today's video, we will be seeing how we can write the robot test cases in Pycharm and what is the difference from writing the test cases in RIDE. So we will see what are the main differences of writing the test case in Pycharm software versus the RIDE software. So let's start this video. In the previous video, we have seen how to download robot framework, how to install the libraries that are required for robot framework, and how to install RIDE on our system. So this is the robot framework IDE which is installed on my system. So if you have not seen the previous video, all these topics are discussed in that video, how we can download the libraries, how we can install the robot framework, and how we can open this RIDE on our system. So you can go and watch that video. For installing Pycharm, what we have to do, we have to go to a Chrome browser and we have to write download Pycharm. So this is the official website, jetbrains.com. Let's click on this link. So there are two versions of Pycharm. One is the professional version and the second one is community version. The professional version is the paid version, which is having a trial period of 30 days, and the community version is a free version and it is an open source version. On my system, I have downloaded the community version of the Pycharm, right? So this is the interface of the Pycharm. Pycharm is mainly used for development of the Python scripts. So let us write our first test case, first in Pycharm and then in robot framework. For writing the first test case, what we have to do, first we have to create a new project. We have to go to file, click on new project, and here we can give the name of our project. Let me name it as robot framework project, and we can select the Python interpreter which we need to use with this project. Either we can create a new environment, virtual environment inside this project, or we can use a previously configured interpreter. So in this case, the Python interpreter is Python 3.9 and this is the location of that Python exe. So I will select this one, previously configured interpreter, and I will click on create. It is asking in this window you have to open the project, or in the new window. I will select this window, right? So this is the project that is created, robot framework project. So for writing the test case in Pycharm, writing the robot test case in Pycharm, what we have to do, we have to right click on this project and click on new. It is up to us if we need to create a directory or we can directly create a new file and write our test case. So let us create a new directory with the name of tests, and inside this tests directory we will create our test cases. For creating test cases, we have to right click on this directory, new and file. And now here we have to give the name of the file by which we have to create that file. So test case set. So this is the name that I have given, test cases set. But we have to keep in mind, for creating a robot file and to write the robot test cases in that file, we have to give the extension as .robot, robot. So when we give this extension as .robot, the Pycharm will consider it as a robot framework file, right? And when I hit enter, as soon as we create that file, the Pycharm automatically suggests that the robot files are found and there are different plugins that are available for that file which we can install. I will show you what is the difference without the plugin and with the plugin which we will be getting. So in Pycharm, this is the process which we have to follow for writing our test case. Now let me show you how we can write our test case in ride. Let me open ride. So this is the ride interface. First we have to create a new project. Here I will create the project with the name of test robot project, and here there are options on this right side. The type of the project is file or directory. We have to select from both of these, file or directory. If we select file, we cannot create a new directories inside this project because it is a type of file. Then we have to directly create our test cases inside that project. But if we select the directory as a type of that project, it will create the directory with the name of this test robot project, and we can create multiple directories inside that project. And the format is robot, txt, tsv or html. We can select any one of these format. So I will select robot and click on OK. So this is the new project that is created, and there is nothing inside this project. So as we have done in Pycharm, first we will create a new directory inside this. So for creating a new directory, right click on the project, new directory is the option, click on it, and here we will give the name of the directory. So here also there is an option to select the formats. It is a robot format or txt or tsv or html format. So here also we will keep the format as robot and click on OK. So this is the folder that is created. This is the directory. So for writing the test cases, what we have to do, first we have to create a test suite. Right click on the test directory, click on new suite, and in this new suite we can create our test cases. So let us name it as test suite. Now I will click on OK. So this is the test suite that will be created. Click on OK. Right, so this is the suite that is created, and you can see the icon of this suite. It is a file type, but the icons of this test and this test robot project is the folder type icon are present. Now for writing the test case, what we have to do, right click on this test suite, select the new test case option. Now I will click on new test case. Here we have to give the name of the test case. Let me name it as demo test case. Click on OK. So this is the first test case that is created, demo test case, and this is the interface where we can write our test case. In ride, this is the UI that is being provided, but if we have to write the test case in the text format, we can click on this option, text edit, and here you can see the test case section is present, and the demo test case is the name of that test case is present. Now if we write anything inside in this section, so for example, let me write something inside this documentation. This test is for demo purpose. Click on enter and now save it. And now if we go to this text edit, you can see the documentation section is automatically populated inside this text section. Right, similarly we can write teardown, timeout, template and tags we can give like that, and in the edit section the tag will be added. But in Pycharm, let me go to Pycharm now. In Pycharm, what we have to do, we have to manually write everything what that is present in the ride. In Pycharm, we do not have this interface for writing the test case. So if we have to create a test case, first of all we have to write this test case section as it is, like it is written here, test cases. then only we can write, inside this only we can write our test case. So if we have to give the documentation, we have to first write the test case name, demo test case, and inside this test case, if we have to write something as a documentation, we have to write documentation. This is the tag that we have to give, and here we can write the documentation regarding the test case. So you can see we have to write the section, the test case section, on our own in the text format, but in RIDE we get the facility of this interface by which we just have to write our keywords or the test case in this section, and it will automatically convert it into the text format, right? So if we have to give tags in the PyCharm, what we have to do? Similarly, as we have given documentation, we will first write the tags section, and then we will give the tag that we want to give. So now coming to the plugins, there are different plugins that can be installed in PyCharm, which helps in some auto suggestions, which can be helpful in writing the test cases. So it is saying install robot framework server plugin. We will not install it directly from here. We will go to settings and then the plugins. So as you can see, there are no plugins related to robot framework that are installed currently. We will go to this marketplace, and here we will search for robot framework. So there are different plugins, as you can see, hyper robot framework language server, IntelliBot patched. So these are the different plugins that are available for installation. What we will do, we will install this one, robot framework language server. Click on install. We will click on restart IDE. It will open the PyCharm again. So now it is restarted. The PyCharm is restarted. And you can see the color of this test case line is changed because we have installed the robot framework plugin. And this icon of this robot file is also changed, if you have noticed. Now the robot icon is coming in the front of this robot file, and the documentation and tags are coming in this golden color. Now what we can do, if we have to now write something like we have to give setup. So in the square bracket, first we have to open the square bracket and write S, and now it will suggest setup is the keyword that we can write. So this is suggested by the robot framework plugin that we have installed. Similarly, we can write teardown. For teardown, we write T, and this is the options that we can write: timeout, template, teardown. We will select teardown. So the plugin will help us in suggesting the words that we can write. This is the only benefit that the plugin will give, right? And before this test cases, we will write these 3 stars. And now we have installed the plugin. So let us press control and space. So these are the different sections which we can add: comments, keywords, settings, task, test case, and variables. Like this, in PyCharm we have to write each and everything on our own in the text format, but in RIDE we get the help of this interface which is provided in this RIDE software. We just have to put the things in this interface, and this text file is automatically created. So in the next videos, we will see how we can write our Selenium test cases using PyCharm and the robot framework. So that's all for this today's video. If you like this video, then please subscribe. Please press the like button. And if you have any suggestions, then please comment in the comment section. Thank you.